With me on the line this morning, I've got Tony O'Reilly from Providence Resources. Tony, good morning.
Good morning. How are you?
Very well, thanks, Tony. It's been a big few weeks for you. Been a little while in the waiting, this news on Barryroe, but bring us up to date on the farm out, this deal here, Tony.
Yeah, so on March 28th, we signed a farm out agreement with a Chinese consortium led by APEC, where they're going to take a 50% working interest in Barryroe, and then they're also going to provide non-recourse financing to Providence and Lansdowne for our 50% share to do a multi-well drilling program next year. So it's been a long time coming. It's a great deal for us. Gives us three wells, three sidetracks, six new take points in the reservoir, and I think it substantially advances Barryroe towards FID and ultimately to through appraisal through to production. And that's what we were looking for. We were looking for a development partner that could not only come and assist us with the short-term drilling, but also have the financial and operational capability to take the project to the next stage. And we feel we have that with this Chinese consortium. Chinese consortium comprises APEC, which is a private Chinese company, backed financially by JIC, which is a state-owned conglomerate here in China. I'm actually in Beijing as we speak. And operationally going to be supported by COSL, China Offshore Services Limited, is one of the world's largest offshore services companies. So we really feel that we have a very good group who can take Barryroe forward.
And you're hoping to close this deal later on in the year, Tony, are you, around about Q3?
Yeah, in Q3. And you know, the deal is signed and everything's agreed. So there's sort of the normal, in any farm out, you always have subject to government approval. So that's Irish government approval, which is a sort of a normal course of action. But in this case, also because Chinese state funds are being used, obviously requires Chinese state approval, hence the timeline to get it done is in Q3.
And your subsidiary, that'll remain the operator initially, will it?
Correct. So Exola will be the operator for the drilling program, for the planning, consenting, and operations, obviously with the support of COSL and APEC, with the money coming from JIC. And then obviously once the drilling campaign is completed, they have the right to take over operatorship.
Can you give us a bit more detail on some of the timelines here, Tony? I mean, realistically, when do you reckon you could be hitting this first well?
Well, I think when you look at the Irish consenting process, you know, it's a 9 to 12 month process now. Since 2015, there's a new act called the PEES Act, which requires a whole different level of consenting than we previously had in Ireland. And in fact, we're the only company to have gone through that consenting process last year with our Druid John Begwell. So we're fully versed in what is required in terms of well work safety cases, rig safety case, oil spill contingency plans, financial responsibility. There's a whole bunch of more regulatory things that you have to do. It's all very doable, but it just takes time. And so realistically, if you're at Q3 closing, you're looking at sort of this time next year for drilling operations commencing. And that's the sort of timeline we're looking at. I mean, if we could do it quicker, we would, but, you know, there are statutory timelines for the regulatory consent. So, you know, they need that. There's a due process you have to go through. And as I say, it's a new timeline, which every operator operating offshore Ireland has to go through. So, you know, as I said, we've gone through it, so we fully understand what needs to be done. So really, from an operational point of view, this time next year, and then you're looking at about a 6 month program of drilling.
In terms of budgets, costs, what are we talking about for this program?
Well, again, the sort of the indicated sort of budget for this, and it just is a demonstration of where costs are these days and why it's such a good time to be doing things with the oil price going up and yet costs still staying remarkably low. I mean, this program is about $100 to $120 million gross. So, you know, and that's, you know, That's for 6 take points in the reservoir. Just to put that in context, when we drilled our Barryroe well back in 2012, that was over $80 million for that well, for one well. So you're clearly benefiting from change in the cost profile in the market. So it is a good time to be doing it.
I mean, what kind of numbers? What are the estimates as to how much oil's at Barryroe?
Well, the audited report by Netherland, Sewell, which we did in 2014, was coverable about 346 million barrels of oil equivalent. So, you know, this is one of the largest undeveloped oil fields in Ireland or indeed the UK. So it's a substantial resource. And really what we're looking to do is to turn the 2C resources, which is the 346 million barrels recoverable, into 2P reserves, and then take it through FID and into development and into production.
And how, I mean, it is early days, but when do you reckon we could be talking about first oil here?
You're talking a number of years, because if you take the drilling programs in 2019 and you get to FID in 2020 sometime, and then you're looking at 2 years certainly of development. So, you know, you're probably looking at 2022, 2023, that sort of timeline. Obviously, if we can fast track it, we will obviously be led by our partners. The great thing about the Chinese consortium is that they're very, very aggressive, and they want to get moving as quickly as possible. So as soon as the deal closes, in quarter three, we'll be ramping up massively on the planning and consenting and getting it ready for drilling as quickly as possible. And then it's a question of what did the drilling results tell you, which will finalize your development plans. Because, you know, whilst we have certain views on the development options we'd like, obviously, the consortium may take a different view based on some of the results we get through the appraisal program. Certainly when we started this process, we were looking at focusing on the eastern portion of the field, which is our kind of early stage production, and the eastern panel, two panels of the field, and that was kind of half the resource space. I think part of the reason we're here this week in China meeting with our partners is actually potentially looking at maybe changing one of the well locations that we have already agreed and maybe going to the west, and that might make it a bigger field development. I can't say too much because we have to go through a process, but, you know, the key point is we're going to get 6 new take points in this reservoir, which will materially advance the project to FID.
Well, you mentioned you're over in China at the moment meeting with your partners. Are you pretty keen on other potential co-venturing opportunities with them?
Yeah, and we've had some preliminary discussions on that, and again, part of the conversation this week was to see what other opportunities there are we could work together. I mean, this group, the strategic joint venture between JIC, APEC, and COSL, this is a group that are going to do meaningful things in the oil and gas industry in many parts of the world. I know they're looking at opportunities in the North Sea. I know they're looking in West Africa and also Southeast Asia. Our deal was probably the first deal that they've announced as a consortium, and they want to do more. And we're very happy. I mean, they've got the capital, they've got the technical know-how and the operational capabilities. So it's just a question of when we look at our portfolio of assets, what other opportunities there may be on appraisal, but also maybe even potentially on exploration. But again, I don't want to say too much at this stage because that's part of some of the conversations that we'll be having.
But certainly sounds exciting times ahead here for Providence Resources, Tony.
It is. I mean, and it's not just Barryroe. I mean, I think as we said, and I gave a proactive presentation the other day, you know, our whole approach has been about a portfolio. So to give our shareholders access to as many opportunities for value uplift scenarios, whether it's high-risk exploration, high-reward, or appraisal projects. And so at last week's proactive presentation, we talked about some of our other assets, obviously Avalon, where Total farmed in last year and took 50% and became operator. They've now, the JV have now elected to convert that from a licensing option to a frontier exploration license. So that's advancing that asset, and that's obviously very, very positive. We also have our New Grange prospect, which we have 80% of, and our partner Cecina have 20%. That's a very large exploration prospect in the southern Porcupine down in the Golden Spur. And that, you know, that is something where we're getting it ready for drilling. So we're actually doing a site survey this summer and getting it drill ready, because we see it as potentially something that we could tack on to another drilling program that somebody else is drilling offshore the West Coast. We could avail of rig share, and so we just want to get all the prep work done on that. So that's quite exciting, and we're running a farm out process on that, and the industry interest is quite good. And it's a huge target. It's about the size of four North Sea blocks. You know, the previous volumetrics estimates that we put out was anything from 13 trillion cubic feet of gas or 9 billion barrels of oil in place. So a significant resource. Yes, it's got risks, but the thing that makes it quite interesting, it is a very shallow well, so it's a very cheap well to drill. I mean, our sort of cost estimates for drilling a well, all in with the planning and consenting, is about $15 million, $15 million. So from a risk-reward point of view, you rarely get opportunities to test such a large structure for such a low cost. So that's why we're seeing some good interaction in the data room from potential farming needs. And then the last thing I mentioned, our proactive invested forum last week, was our Dunquin project, which of course we drilled in 2013. It was we found a large low saturation oil accumulation. It was breached, so the oil was immobile. But there are two structures. There's Dunquin North and Dunquin South, and we drilled Dunquin North. And so the partnership under the operatorship of ENI have gone back and said, well, what can we do to further de-risk and differentiate between Dunquin North and Dunquin South? And so last year we licensed 3D seismic over it. And I think it's kind of well known now within, certainly technically within the industry, is that you get a clear difference between Dunquin North, the breach structure, and Dunquin South, where we can't see the same sort of breaching structures. So I think it substantially de-risks Dunquin South, and I would have to say it will be a candidate for drilling. I can't say when, but certainly it's very encouraging, the results we have. So again, our whole focus at Providence is just about pushing as many projects forward as we can, doing commercial deals. I mean, the last 12 months, we've done 4 farm-outs. And I don't think there's many companies who can say they've done that many farm out. And that's what shareholders want. They want activity across the portfolio, and hopefully we can continue to deliver on that.
I wish you all the best, Tony. Really good to speak to you. Thanks very much.
Andrew, thank you very much. Take care.